हेलो एवरीबॉडी। लास्ट टाइम इन द मॉड्यूल वन वी टोल्ड यू अबाउट द कोर्स एंड अबाउट अलजेब्रिक टोपोलॉजी इन जनरल। वी ऑल्सो शोड हाउ अ फंडामेंटल प्रॉब्लम इन अलजेब्रा इन टोपोलॉजी इज शोन टू बी नॉट सॉल्वेबल बाय सॉल्विंग ए करेस्पॉन्डिंग प्रॉब्लम इन group theory. This was due to Noriko. So today we will introduce the concept of homotopy. Allah, the two problems that we have stated, namely lifting problem and extension problem. So let us see how homotopy, for what homotopy is and how homotopy is going to affect this thing. So let me tell you something about homotopy itself. In analysis, often we need to approximate a given function by nicer functions, maybe sometimes linear maps or smooth maps and so on. This is one side. This approximation is something that you have to keep in mind. On the other hand, in physics, there is one certain property, namely those properties which have this particular property, they are the ones which are more interesting one for physicists, namely called stable property. In terms of, for me who don't know much physics, what it means is the following. Suppose you take a system and disturb it a little bit. The system should return to the original position by on its own. That little bit is to be made precise, and that precise way is nothing but homotopy. We will come to that one. Okay, the classical idea, which was all the way back to Lagrange, okay, which describes this, the perturbation is what is called, okay. Mathematically is the notion of homotopy. But the modern definition of homotopy that we are going to study is due to Brauer. Okay? So, let us make a definition. Take two topological spaces X and Y. Let I denote the closed interval 0, 1. Then any continuous function from X cross I to Y will be called a homotopy. Whenever you have a function like that, the first variable is the space variable. The second variable you can think of as time variable. That is why we denote it by x, t. So when you fix a time variable t, you get a function from x to y at the time t. So these functions are called, are denoted by little h t. So often people in classically, they used to think of this as a family of functions from x to y, the family being indexed by the set I. It is very important. It is not just a set, it is the space, time space, namely the interval in, you know, some interval in R. So that's that continuity of the time is very important. So the continuity with respect to t also, it is not a separate continuity in x and continuity in t. That is not the correct thing. What we need is a joint continuity from the product space x cross I to y. Such a thing is called homotopy. So this is the modern definition. Okay, symbolically, whenever such a homotopy exists, the homotopy from H naught, which we may call it as F, and H one, the time one, which becomes G. Okay, so whenever such a thing exists, we say F is homotopic to G and write it in this way. All right, so that is a definition. Now, if you have a homotopy H, you can define another homotopy H tilde, by just reversing the time, namely t being replaced by 1 minus t. Then at time 0, it will be g first. Then when time 1, it will be f. That will be homotopy from g to f. So what this shows is, whenever there is a homotopy from f to g, it's a homotopy from g to f. So the relation, if f is related to g by this equal, whatever this symbol, then that relation is symmetric. That is the meaning of this one. So on the other hand, it is very easy to see that f is related to f. All that I have to do is h of xt, ignore t, is f of h of xt is fx, right? So that will be the identity homotopy itself from f to f. So the relation is reflexive. Finally, to see that it is transitive, suppose you have a homotopy g from g to h in addition to homotopy from f to g, then you can put these two things together. It is called juxtaposing one homotopy with another homotopy, juxtaposing. So what is the meaning of that? This is explained here technically, completely, rigorously. Namely, in the first half of the interval, you define it to be h. Only thing is, you fill up the interval by speeding up, you take the double speed, x going to 2t, you know, h, f of xt going to h of x, 2t. Exactly similar, you have to do it in the other half of the interval. Only thing is, now the 0 is taken by half and 1 is taken by 1 only. So you have to do shifting also. So this will become x, 2t minus 1 applied to g, applied to that one in the interval half to t less than equal to 1. So such a function is automatically continuous because the first half of x cross 0 to half, it is h, that is continuous. In the second half, x cross half to 1, it is g, it is continuous. And on the intersection, which is x cross half, it's both, all these things are closed subsets. The two functions agree. So there is a one single function, though there are two formulas. Okay. So this f becomes a homotopy from now h x 0, which is f, to g x 1, which is h. This shows that this relation, whatever you wrote, is an equivalence relation. Reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. Okay. So here is a picture which tells you this x cross 0 to 1. In the half part, x cross 0 to half, I have taken h. Then the second half, I am putting a g. So they patch up because x, on x cross half, what is the function? It is the function g there, little g. Here it is f, it is g here, it is here h. So f homotopic to g, g homotopic to h means f is homotopic to h. Set of homotopy classes of functions maps from x to y. It will be temporarily denoted by double bracket xy. This is a set now. You see, already we have started doing algebraic topology here. Started with spaces from x to y and maps from x to y. We have constructed purely a set of equivalence classes here of functions here. These are basic objects of study in algebraic topology, these sets. An element of this double bracket xy is always represented by some map f from x to y, and that map will be denoted, that class will be denoted by double bracket f. Now we have to study what happens under compositions and so on, and that is the next lemma. Alright, next lemma says that suppose f and g are homotopy from x to y. Now suppose there is a map from w to x, then you can first take alpha and then follow by f, first take alpha followed by g. When you have two different maps, they were themselves will be homotopy. Similarly, suppose there is a map beta from y to z. Now you can take first f from x to y, then beta, or first take g and then beta. So those will be also homotopy. All these follows if f is homotopy to g. Pre-composition and post-compositions of homotopies is a homotopy. So this is the message of this lemma 1-1, fundamental lemma. Proof is very easy. All that you have to do is corresponding compositions of homotopies. Starting with a homotopy H from F to G, take H, composite alpha cross identity. What is the meaning of alpha cross identity? On the W part, remember alpha is a map from W to X, right? Alpha. So on the W part, it is alpha. On the I part, okay, it is the identity. So alpha of W comma T is nothing but alpha W comma T. Then apply H. That will give you homotopy between what? Between F composite alpha and G composite alpha. Similarly, if you take beta composite H, that will give you homotopy of beta composite F and beta composite G. So those are the proofs, which is very straightforward. Now we can sum up what the effect of this lemma on these sets. Look at the starting with a pair of topological spaces. We immediately wrote down this set. What is this set? Take a continuous function from here to here, take its homotopy class. So this is a set of all such homotopy classes. This assignment has some wonderful natural properties with respect to compositions. If you pre-compose alpha, you pre-compose this class with an alpha from W to X, a function from X to Y will become a function from W to Y. So what happens to the class? The class will become a whole class. There's no change. That is the whole point here. So alpha check from XY to WY, these are now sets, will be well defined. A homotopy class here goes to homotopy class here, because if two functions are homotopic here, alpha composite, F composite alpha, G composite alpha, they will be homotopic here. So that is the whole idea. Similarly, you can compose with once more. So alpha and beta from Z to W, then alpha from W to X, then what you get is alpha composite beta check is beta composite alpha check. So this is all pre-composition. Exactly same thing happens on the compositions on the right also. Then we get new composite gamma. Now this time we have a notation, the checks are suffixes. They are superscripts. Here it is prescripts. Equal to mu check composite gamma check. Okay. Moreover, one more important property is that if you take identity map, then identity check is nothing but identity, whichever way you take, either pre-composite or post-composite. Okay. How to get this one, I have told you. It is just lemma 1.1 that we have just seen, along with one simple property, namely associativity of functional compositions. F composite G, bracket you put, composite H, you can put the brackets on the other side. F composite bracket G composite H. So that is associativity. That is all you have to keep using. In fact, let us just clarify this one. That is, no hanky-panky is being done. Okay, just be very sure. So let us verify one of the properties, the first one, namely start with alpha comes to beta, the upper check I want to show is equal to beta check composite alpha check. It interchanges the slots. That's very important. Whereas if you take the lower check, then it will be alpha check lower, beta check lower in the same order. So let us verify this. So what I have to do? Operate on f. F is a function from x to y on both sides and verify that they are the same. So I start with this one. What is the definition of alpha composite beta as a function? Check f. It is f composite this function alpha composite beta. Now use the associativity of this composition. It's the same thing as f composite alpha composite beta. But then this is namely beta check of this function, f of alpha, f composite alpha. But f composite alpha is alpha check of f. So beta check of alpha check of f, it is just beta composite alpha check check. Right? Okay, exactly same way you can verify the other one also. As I have told you, I keep repeating this, the workspace of algebraic topologies in the whole, later on we can make it smaller and smaller, in the whole is all topological spaces. And for each pair of topological spaces, the set is namely homotopy class of maps from X to Y, of homotopy classes of maps from X to Y. This is the one which you are interested in, not exactly the maps, but the homotopy classes. Okay. Modern mathematics is full of such collections of assignment. So we have assigned, starting with a pair of topological spaces, you assign. So you now study this set. This set, when you take special cases, will have lots of structures, different kinds of structures. And that's what we would like to study. Okay. So the property of this assignment, which we have seen just in the previous remark, so those properties are themselves called, you know, they are categorized, they are, you can say, they have been put inside a kind of discipline, it's called categories and functions, which is part and parcel of algebraic topology. These categories and functors gives you the basic language required to express so many complicated ideas into simple language. Okay, this has been, you know, this is a very modern discovery, I would say. People like Euler, Gauss, etc. They never had this kind of language. Even Riemann didn't have, even Hilbert didn't have this. So if you try to read their papers, it will be very, very difficult for us. It's an entirely different kind of language. Okay, let us take a closer look at these classes. Suppose I take a special case, namely, the domain is just a single point that I denote by your bracket star, where a single point, singleton space. Then what is this space, set of homotopy classes of maps from X to Y? To understand this, first of all, you must see what are maps from a singleton space. Any function from a singleton space will be automatically continuous. There is only one topology there. So what are all functions? A singleton space, what is the meaning of function? You have to just mention one point in the space Y. As soon as you mention that, the function is well defined. That the domain singleton goes to that point, right? Therefore, this is nothing but set of points in Y. Now, what is a homotopy? A star cross I is nothing but homeomorphic token I itself. So they are functions from I, of course, continuous functions, maps. So these maps, you must have studied, they are called paths. The starting point is some point, that is one function. End point is another function. So these things are connected by a path. The equivalence classes of such things are nothing but path components of Y. So this is one of the simplest algebraic topology invariant. Okay, this is homotopy invariant which we have constructed now. So this was there already in point set topology, right? The path connected components, the number of path connected components is something different from all other concepts like compactness, separatance, T1ness, T2ness, various things. So this is a quantitative invariant as compared to qualitative invariants. So all topological invariants in algebraic topology, they will be of this type. They will be quantitative, not qualitative. Okay? Quantity just doesn't mean that just the cardinality. There is more, much more than that. So you can say it's algebra. There are structures there, of course, like groups, abelian groups, rings, and so on. All right? So we produce in algebraic topology and study various such invariants of topological spaces, which are not only sets, but more algebraic structures on them, rings, modules, and so on. This basic idea of assigning algebraic invariant such as groups and rings instead of numbers goes back to Emmy Noether. Before that, people were just counting the numbers, like path-connected components, number of. Okay, if not, number of arcs needed to cut down a given something. For example, look at R. You remove one point, it gets disconnected. Look at the circle. You remove one point, it is still connected. So you need two points. So this is the kind of things they are studying. Okay, so Emmy Noether says, don't worry about such things. Best thing is to do, assign group structures to them. Okay, so this was one of the landmark contribution of Emmy Noether. Emmy Noether has done a lot of physics also. So now it is time for us to reformulate our fundamental topological questions in terms of homotopy. Okay. So first question we are going to change. That was lifting problem. Remember that. So we are going to make it into homotopy lifting property. The homotopy lifting problem, then things which have satisfied certain things will go homotopy lifting property. So fix a map P from E to B. Given a function X, F from X to B, question is, does there exist a map G from X to E such that P composite G is homotopic to F instead of equality. Everything else is the same. Instead of equality here, replace it by homotopy equivalence. Okay, so here we are asking, can F be lifted through P up to homotopy? This is the meaning of, this is another way of saying the same problem. Obviously, the original question, when you have to equality here, okay, has an affirmative answer, then the change question, I mean Q1A I'm talking about, it also has affirmative answer because equality implies homotopy equivalence also. But the converse is not correct. Even this is equivalent, if this is solved, there may not be any function g such that p composite g is equal to actually f. Okay, but this simple observation that homotopy equivalence, okay, will be assured if there are if there was actually a map, homotopy lifting would have. If this is not true, namely you cannot lift even up to homotopy, then of course you cannot lift the map at all. Right? Therefore, a negative question, negative answer would have given you a negative answer. So even this much survey is given by this map is of importance to us. Okay. But what we want to use is we will ignore this portion. We will only solve or answer whether something is homotopically can be lifted or not. And we are satisfied by that. So we will pretend as if the problem is over when you have lifted a function up to homotopy. What does that mean? We just make a hypothesis, namely, assume if something can be lifted up to homotopy, then it can be lifted. Okay, so this is called homotopy lifting property. This is an axiom, you know, on the function, on the map from P from E to B. Okay, so let me state this one correctly. Rigorously. So start with a map P from A to B. So we are given a homotopy from X cross I to B, okay, and a map G from X to E such that when you take P composite G, that's a map from X to B, right? It is the function f of x0, meaning the starting point of this homotopy. The starting point of this homotopy, namely, suppose this is f of x0 is small fx, then that map has been already lifted. That is g. Okay, so this is part of the hypothesis. So all this is called homotopy lifting data. This much is given. Okay. We say P satisfies the homotopy lifting property if each such data, homotopy lifting data, will give rise to an actual homotopy from G from now X cross I to E. See, this homotopy was X cross I to B. Now the lifting, this whole thing is gone up to E such that when you compose with G, compose with P, it comes to F. And the starting point of this homotopy, G of X0, is the given function G from X to E. Okay. If this happens for every X, and every f and every g, there must be a capital G like this. Then we say P satisfies homotopy lifting property. Understand? So let me put this one in a figure, in a picture, which you will just easy to remember. This is the picture. So here you have X cross 0, G to E, and here you have X cross I, okay? And this is your inclusion map, eta. X cross 0 goes to X cross 0 under this inclusion map. F is the homotopy. At the starting point, it is G. Composed with P is this F. This much is given. As soon as you are given here, you must have this dotted arrow, capital G, from X cross I to E. When you compose it, it must be F. So this triangle is commutative. And this triangle is also commutative, same thing as if you restrict it to x cross 0, it must be orientation. So this is the conclusion and this is the data. For every such data, if you can come here from this part, that means P is a, has homotopy lifting property. Okay, so this is a definition. So this will take care of all our botherations about point set topology, and we can do only on algebraic topology. This is the whole idea. Such special classes of maps are, you may say, very rare. No, that is not true. There will be plenty of them, and one such class we are going to study very rigorously in this course, namely covering projections. The notion of homotopy lifting property is important enough to make another definition, namely such things are called Hurwitz vibrations or just vibrations. This is because Hurwitz was the first one to notice it and study it quite deeply. So people call it Hurwitz vibration. Okay. What is the meaning of vibration? It is a map from one space to another space which has the homotopy lifting property. Okay. So this is what I am telling you. Hurwitz was the first to recognize this one. So one important case of vibration will be studied in this course, and that is covering projection. All right. So we will take up the second question a little later, namely in the next module. So today, this is enough. Thank you.